So you have these nebulous jump velocity and gravity variables that you use to control how your character jumps and falls. If you don't like how they feel, you tweak them, try again, then rinse and repeat. It's a tedious process, but it really doesn't have to be. Using a bit of math, we can define our jump using real, understandable parameters and create our jump velocity and gravity values at runtime. Here's how we'll do it. We're going to break our jump into three variables: the height of the jump, the time it takes to reach the peak of the jump, and the time it takes to reach the ground after hitting the peak. The last one will let us add a bit more weight to our jump by making the character fall faster than they rise. All sorts of platformers, like Mario, do this to make the jump feel more satisfying. This tutorial will work for both 2D and 3D since it's just some basic projectile motion math, but for the sake of visualization, I'm making a 2D platformer. I'm going to assume you already have a basic character controller set up. If not, you can copy this template I have. The character moves based on velocity, which is affected horizontally by player input, and calls a jump function when the jump button is pressed. Now we just have to fill in the rest. Start by creating three export variables: jump height, jump time to peak, and jump time to descent, all of which are floats. Under that, create three onReady variables: jump velocity, jump gravity, and fall gravity, which are also floats. Now comes some math. Don't worry about understanding exactly what we're doing yet, just follow along. Set jump velocity equal to 2.0 times jump height divided by jump time to peak. Then set jump gravity equal to -2.0 times jump height divided by jump time to peak times jump time to peak. Fall gravity uses the exact same equation as jump gravity, just substituting jump time to peak with jump time to descent. To put it simply, these equations for our velocity and gravity variables are derived from these projectile motion and linear velocity equations. We just rearrange them using some algebra to solve for each given variable. I don't want to bore people who are only here to learn about quickly getting good jump code, though, so if you want to go more in depth on what the math means, I'd recommend this GDC talk called Math for Game Programmers: Building a Better Jump. Lastly, if you're working in 2D, surround the equation in parentheses and multiply by -1. This is because our equations are assuming up is a positive y value and down is negative. In Godot 2D, however, the opposite is true. We want gravity to be positive and velocity to be negative. If you're in 3D, the equations will be fine how they were before. Now, with all that out of the way, we have our variables filled out and automatically calculated at runtime. We just need to use them. Create a function called getGravity. It's going to return either jump gravity or fall gravity, depending on whether we're moving up or down. To do so, write return jump gravity if velocity.y is less than 0, else fall gravity. Now replace any direct references to any gravity variables with getGravity. Here I use it in physics process, where I add getGravity multiplied by delta to velocity.y. Finally, in our jump function, we're just going to set velocity.y to jump velocity. Set up the variables however you want in the editor. The nice thing is, if you want to change it, you already know what to do. If you want to reach the peak more quickly, just change jump time to peak, or if you want to jump higher, increase jump height. Here's some values I like, but of course it's going to depend from game to game. As you can see, we really do jump 100 pixels high in half a second. With that, you have easy-to-use jump variables that will make your prototyping and game design process less of a tedious guess-and-check ordeal. Again, if you care for the maths, please check out the GDC talk linked in the description. Also, the full movement script we made here is available on GitHub, so if you run into any problems or need to double-check the equations, you can find the code using the link in the description.